his stuff, and it's very interesting to say that because I believe PS2 can help Stoners quite a little bit. But all right, oh nice up B out of shield over here, getting him. And yes, Spargo looking a lot better now. Oh my god! Finishing top.
When he lands that down, that forward air spike on stage, he's so consistent about throwing up that up smash and just kind of just reacting to it. It's kind of scary. I mean, he's gotten a few kills like that tonight.
Oh, I agree with you, man. It's going to be a pretty good start, though.
It's like a frame or two faster for the most part, and it's pretty insane. Wow, minecart into Z-drop into building on this man.
He's building the percentage 80 almost on that. I mean, Rob, combo dumpster, you know, has that. Every character, you know, styles on Rob. But that was insane stuff there from Spargo. Very good job building the blocks up, building the damage up, and starting to build away the momentum and starting to steal this lead away, Max.
That up air, man. We call him Meta Light in this household.
Nah, three stalking Mr. E with Steve would be too much, Spargo. Spargo. It would be too much. No. Spargo, please don't do this.
No!
In my opinion, has one of the best neutrals in the entire game.
So using the buff as well too for the limit, you know, he really showed off limit. He got double kills with limit cross slash.
Yeah.
And
like,
there he is right there with limit. Only been 20 seconds into the game.
Oh, and he lands it again!
That boy, DDD. Ask Spargo to main Isabel. Oh my god! There's no way! Dude, Spargo is... He is not done with this tourney at all. In fact, some would say... He reset... Oh! Makes a stone wall so that Joker can't get through! Spargo now has a diamond sword. For those of you new to Smash, that diamond sword hits very quickly, and it's very hard, and allows Steve to get some pretty insane combo chains. Also get kills pretty early with back air. Oh!
Nice
catch on that recovery.
He hit so many of those this tournament.
Oh my god, this man Spargo is not playing.
Oh my god,
catching the jump.
Oh my god!
Into it, man. Grand Finals, Juicebox 30. Skittles versus Spargo, Steve versus Enderman, Grand Finals. Could you ever imagine saying this for a Smash tournament?
Didn't we see this before for a little
bit? Not Steve and Alex, this is Steve and Enderman.
Oh, okay. I mean, yeah, this is definitely good versus evil here. But yeah, we'll have to see how it plays out. I have no idea how Skittles, Enderman plays at all, but I can tell you for sure that is a 30-second zero to death.
Right. Like, that is... That's some good stuff. Yeah, this man knows his spacing no matter what stage he's on. Oh, no, tech that. You teched it.
He teched it, but it still died.
He said he's on the way with 1 minute left. He might clutch it. Yes, might clutch it. Mercedes. Oh my god!
Not enough. But Spargo has to jump using it.
Oh my goodness,
oh
my Spargo!
God. Oh, that was... Kinda huge.
The thief
kinda
in the
huge.
Night.
Now Spargo is in a tough position still, but this is like
that's a huge game breaker.
This though. Is this could just happen. It could just snap of the fingers.
40%. Here we go. Back air.
Dude, Spargo is going in, dude.
He misses the back air.
Caught his jump. This is a horrifying position to be in.
Another one.
Doesn't have a jump.
He's gonna.
Oh!
He's
that's
got it.
It. That's
he's
it.
He's got it.
No move on the shield is very very smart. Amazing recovery from Spargo. Oh my god. That was so good! Oh, the down B! Oh! Again! Guess the- Okay, that's a kill! This is the turning point! Leon needs this game!
Man, if anything...
oh no, that's so sad.
We're closer to Rob than Minecraft Steve.
Either way, man, I did not know Spargo was picking up this character, but honestly, it's kind of, I feel like Steve and where he's going to fit in the meta, and Enderman, obviously, where they're going to fit in the meta is kind of this anti-zoner character. It can work out where you build up that wall with the heavier building materials, so you don't want to use, like, you know, the crappy stuff. You want to use the good stuff so the projectiles can't get through it, but there we go.
Tatsumaki over here. All right, still nothing. Yes, still nothing. Nice, nice. Okay. Spargo's got him trapped at the ledge, bro, like super well. And he's probably gonna be getting everything here, yes.
Gonna see if Angel can answer back. 151 right now, taking a little bit of damage off of that limit break blade beam. Oh, oh no, Spargo.
Oh, no air dodge, this is rough. Okay, good delay on Angel. That definitely would have been a stock if you got the other part of that up B. But yeah, as you're talking about that Nair is like,
I'll be curious to see how Spargo approaches. It's like a lot of empty hops, a lot of like kind of like bays. You just saw the side B, which he's been doing all day, basically just. That should have been a spike.
Yeah. Oh, speaking of potential game, unless he's able to make some real magic happen, these falling nairs are good. He's spacing them really well. It just seems like such a hard matchup, man. The frame data on Cloud is so good.
Yeah, and it's clear that Spargo's comfortable like using limit as like a speed
that's
boost,
it.
And that's the boost right there.
Look at my comeback,
dude. But baning Zelda's in his brawl, dude, that's crazy. He deserves everything that he's getting right now.
Yo, like Zelda hasn't really been ever like a good character. Like the best she's been is in melee when she returned to Ridge.
But even then, this is a really tough hill to climb, and Spargo is so good at catching the wave Dragon's trying to land.
This
17.8%. Ledge trap situation, Spargo can push this right back, but Chag says, no, listen, it's my turn to attack.
Oh my god!
Cloud versus Sheik. Solid gold.
Oh no!
From the ledge to an uppy limit, Paolo really needs to adapt to that.
Exactly. Right now, Pablo is still with a little bit of lead, which is fading as soon as I say so. And right now, Spargo using excellently the platforms.
And just like that, the game goes back and forth. Like, Pablo had a huge advantage, and now it's Spargo who has the advantage here. And almost limit. Yep.
We get the Genkai Okaru and let it rip.
What a read.
To get that perfect game when you could have just ended it. Like, that's
you're
what
right.
I'm saying.
That's true.
That's what I'm saying.
Right. Yes. In our own ways, we have a point.
We're both saying the same thing.
Game two now on PS2. I can't really say that the stage didn't factor. I think he should have switched, but.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, not only is Spargo just looking comfortable on this stage, but oftentimes, especially when you're just starting out, Wally up air setting up into that side B, I don't think.
But no, Spargo comes back, gets Lemon, gets the Jogo out of this. Is exactly what he doesn't want right now. Side B right here.
Spargo, I mean, he's really kind of just running away with this.
What we saw in that first game was great for Cola, but if you notice that, like, yeah, Cola had a very, very, very.
Oh, good lord.
Okay, well, he just ran right up and did it. Nice tic tac toe. And he is just reading all these rolls. And again, that's how you fight Sonic. Beat him to the punch. Try to figure out where he's going to be, and then get there before he does and make him pay for it. Because like Muhammad Ali said, you just cannot hit what your eyes can't see. But sometimes, if you can get there before him, you'll be in a good spot to turn around forward smash.
Getting that first stock, pretty easy. 56% to the 72. To the zero, sorry. But it was 56%, now he's up to 72. But yeah, he got that first stock. Barely taking any type of damage. Now Spargo, though, I mean, even if he does lose the stock early, as long as he can do stuff like this and keep it even, we're fine.
Significantly better start from Snow Good Pop. For one, he did damage before getting to 100%.
Yeah.
So already a much better start. Actually has a lead, even though it was very short-lived. And I want to see So Good Pop. Is limit better on...
Right there, the DI in. He got called out by Spargo, and look at that beautiful conversion. Almost got it into the up tilt if he had actually dashed just a little bit further.
Yo, it's like Cloud just keeps going. Spargo's like, yeah, I got that limit blade beam, and then like we're just gonna keep going up airs and airs.
Fun fact too. I'm interesting to see Spargo playing right now. This is the first time I've seen him since the new patch, which just came out a few days ago. Added Byleth to the game, and also came with some significant Cloud buffs. That's not one of them, but that is going to get kill, and Spargo up 3 stocks to 1 right.
Get himself out of his advantage, but that was a very awkward one. Dash attack not going to connect. Oh, but that one will. Fair into dash attack, too.
Gets him with the back air. Oh, yes. Lands him with a limit cross slash off the stage.